This is the kickoff of our prime card for one championship anew tomorrow. Big height and reach advantage going the way of Hanzi Hao. Mini Zututo, as I said, is taken on Tukatatang Pepainzai and Nongo Ganga Dao. Lost to both, but neither could stop him, could finish him. Just to distinguish now, folks, in one super series, all of our Muay Thai contests will be in 4-ounce gloves. All of our kickboxing contests will be in larger gloves. High left roundhouse kick there from Hanzi Hao, a glancing right hand from Mehdi Zatut. Jab there from Hanzi Hao. Good sliding jab from the Chinese athlete. Outside leg kick. Catch and counter from Mehdi. Couldn't get the counter, got the catch okay.
Mehdi Zatut seems to be comfortable counter-striking. He's waiting for Hanzi Hao to go, and then he's answering right back. Hanzi Hao, Mehdi Zatut says Hanzi Hao only has one direction, that's straight ahead. So he wants to try to utilize lateral footwork. But right now, he's just kind of standing right in front of him, moving forward and back.
Very aggressive start here from Hanzi Hao of China. The Chinese came close to winning their first one Super Series world title in Kuala Lumpur at the end of last year. They had two bites at the cherry, but neither that were successful. It will be a change in fortunes in 2020 for Team China in one Super Series. They do have a mixed martial arts world champion, of course, in Zhong Jinan, the strawweight women's world champion. Mehdi Zatut, 75-39-1 Muay Thai record. The former WBC world champion, ISKA world champion, two-time French national champion, Mehdi Zatut. Hanzi Hao, 61-17, the Top King Muay Thai world champion. There are many people who believe that Hanzi Hao may be a good bet for a world title tilt in 2020. He's already had one in one Super Series unsuccessfully. Good left hand there from Hanzi Hao. There's the counter from Mehdi. Coming over the top with that right.
He's starting to get more comfortable. He's starting to get relaxed. And he's also starting to drift, but he's moving. He's circling left, and that's into the power side of Hanzi Hao. But Mehdi Zatut seems to be okay handling the power of Hanzi Hao.
Left hand, full extension there from Hanzi Hao. They tie up. Referee Elias Delapsis breaks both men. Skipping high left roundhouse kick there from Mehdi Zatut. Smiles at Hanzi Hao. Good low check from Hanzi Hao. Powers off the low check too.
Some early action. You could see Hanzi Hao threw the right kick. Mehdi Zatut caught it. And he was waiting, and then Hanzi Hao just answered with a beautiful little off-balancing right hand.
This is the first match of our prime card between Hanzi Hao of China and Mehdi Zatut of Algeria. Via France, via Thailand these days. There's the catch and counter from Mehdi Zatut. Hanzi Hao smiling at him.
Switching
to Southpaw Stance Dragon.
He was smiling because he landed that push kick. It was a clean rear leg push kick that landed. Mehdi Zatut caught it. And then he took a couple extra steps, which you're not allowed to do under this rule set. Mehdi Zatut needs to be a little more active this time. He can't wait for Hanzi Hao to initiate. He's got to be the one going first. He's got to apply that pressure.
Both men trade roundhouse kicks. Good low check there on the right leg of Mehdi Zatut. Zatut back to orthodox stance. He dabbled with southpaw earlier on. Hanzi Hao edges forward. Zatut should have followed through with the right hand. Hanzi Hao straight left, followed by a crossing right elbow from the Chinese athlete.
Doubles up on that left roundhouse kick. Does Mehdi Zatut. You can start to see him. He's getting a little bit more relaxed. He's starting to faint a little bit more, but he's not going first. Hanzi Hao is the one that's going. Now Mehdi Zatut starts pushing forward. Nice little answer back from Hanzi Hao. Let's see what Mehdi Zatut could do. Nothing.
Possibility there for Mehdi could have been to catch that kicking leg and then let go, throw the spinning back elbow. Elias Delapsis lets them ride the clinch a little. Doesn't see enough action and breaks them. 80 seconds remaining, second round of three. Don't forget, three judges here are scoring this round by round. Now, if you're scoring at home, folks, get out your phone, your little notepad, and you give 10 points for the winner of the round, 9 points for the less dominant athlete of the round. As an accidental groin strike.
You can see Mehdi Zatoud, he fakes the push kick off of the right leg, skips in with the left knee, and just catches Hansa Hao, maybe with the foot.
Referee Delapsis gets us back underway. Skipping right hand there from Hansi Hao. Inside leg kick from the Chinese athlete. Good right hand down the center corridor from Hansi Hao.
You can see some elements of Mehdi Zatoud's game that are similar to Alaverdi Ramazanov. How they both kind of switch stances. They have that same little stutter step and skip that they like to land. Beautiful right hands landed by Mehdi Zatoud.
Triple right hand from Mehdi Zatoud. And a caution there from Alias Delapsis in that exchange.
I think he was just cautioning him on a catching and then firing back like that. You got to let it go. Nice redirect.
Beautiful dump there from Mehdi Zatoud. You see the aggressor meter has now been turned up by the Algerian. A tango in centering back towards the ropes now. High knee from Hansi Hao. Look for the elbows here. Now it's a knee from Hansi Hao to the liver. Doubles up on it off the left leg. Make it in triplicate. And Mehdi looks to dump him again. Strength on the inside and technique from the veteran Mehdi Zatoud. Two down, one to go. Here in Northern Bangkok, we're expecting a sellout for the hottest ticket in town. One championship, a new tomorrow. You're watching the first bout of our prime card. Mehdi Zatoud and Hansi Hao, one Super Series Muay Thai, 4 ounce gloves, knees, elbows, all the good stuff.
I definitely think in the second round, we got to see Mehdi Zatoud establish a little bit of dominance in the southpaw stance. I like him coming out in southpaw. It gives Hansi Hao a little bit of a different look, and he is able to land that straight left hand down the middle.
Crossing elbow there from Hansi Hao. Referee Delapsis breaks them. Good outside leg kick. Popping right from Hansi Hao. Down the center goes Mehdi Zatoud. Cracking third round so far. You saw a crossing elbow off the right arm there from Hansi Hao. Zatoud circling into the power side of Hansi Hao. Going to be careful there. Maybe should drift off to his right, not to his left. He walks into those right hands or those right round kicks of the Chinese athlete.
Hansi Hao is a lot more comfortable attacking when Mehdi Zatoud's going right-handed. The minute Mehdi Zatoud switches to left hand, he's a little bit more hesitant to come in. But when Mehdi Zatoud's right-handed, you can see him flurrying in, landing some shots and trying to close that distance inside that clinch.
Touch gloves. Inside leg kick from Mehdi Zatoud. Hansi Hao skips forward. This is a very close contest, folks. There's no doubt about it. First round, a good one I felt for Hansi Hao. Second round, a good one I felt for Mehdi Zatoud. Anyone's for the taking with 1:05 remaining, third and final.
You definitely see Hansi Hao has stepped up the aggression. He understands the importance of this third round and how close it might actually be.
Nice transition, right hand to clinch, uppercut elbow, crossing elbow, folds him in half with the knee. That's Muay Thai 101 there from Hansi Hao of China. And the way he seamlessly moves fluidly between the hands, the legs, the elbows, the knees, it's nice to see from Hansi Hao. It's representing the pure art of Muay Thai. And what better place to do it than here in Bangkok? Oh, my word, he got the taste slapped out of his mouth on that one.
And Zatoud landed a massive right hand. You can see him coming in with the two, one and then trying to come right over the top with that big left, that big right hand.
Another right hand there from Hansi Hao. Mehdi tries him, mate, eats an uppercut elbow. Threads that elbow so well off the right arm, just Hansi Hao. And Mehdi Zatoud plays to the crowd after dumping the Chinese athlete. Final seconds. It is going to go down to the judges here. Does the aggression in the third round.
That was an ultra close third and final. The whole match was really close. You can see Hansi Hao marching forward, landing a beautiful little hook right there as Zatoud tried to land the roundhouse. Mehdi Zatoud initiates to come in with that jab, scoring beautifully with the one.
decision from the blue corner, Mighty Zato.
The kicks on both of these striking machines, phenomenal. And it's Sami Sana who draws first, checks the low kick of Sogra. Inside leg from Sogra. Overhand right from Sami Sana. You can see the reach differential going the way of the Frenchman.
Yeah, he's got a big reach advantage, and I want to see how he tries to use it. Throwing the jab, throwing that push kick. There's the jab.
Catches the roundhouse kick, sweeps up the support leg. Nice timing there from Sami Sana.
And you can just hear the shins collide on that one.
Left hook from Sana. Hands up very high on the Frenchman. First time competing with four ounce gloves inside of a cage. Roundhouse kick there from Sogra. Look for the counter overhand right to Sami Sana. They lock up, no knees traded. Referee Ulnari breaks them. Front kick from Sogra, Pitt India Academy. Thai boxers do tend to adopt their gym name as their name. Yeah, Sogra is called Sogra in the Academy.
Which is also why we had two papaya ties on the card tonight. They're not brothers, just from the same gym.
Inside leg kick from Sogra, thrusts out the jab. Sami Sana coming forward. Jab falls short for the Frenchman. Gets out of the way of the outside leg kick. Inside leg kick, a little late on the check there, Sami Sana. Should have gone for the counter right hand. He thought about it. Certainly the distancing was there. Left hook from Sami Sana, wades in with the left hand. Then the right hand follow up, couldn't connect. Long reaching step through jab from Sogra. Sami Sana just fakes off the left. Sakyank tattoos all over the back here of Sami Sana. Outside leg kick from Sogra. Dead center of the cage. Both men with the gloves up high. 35 seconds remaining in the first. Action counter. Gets the second bite of the cherry. Gets the takedown there. Sweeps up the support leg. Does Sogra.
Sami Sana continues his march forward, trying to put pressure on Sogra, keep him on his back foot, but Sogra is not intimidated by it. He's countering quite well.
Sami Sana should be able to keep Sogra at bay with a jab of that. Cheap kicks or the front kicks alone with his reach. Not the case, however. Sogra slings towards the lead leg, and we go to the towels at the end of one.
Some of the action in that first round. Sana stepping in, nice counter right hand from Sogra. He slides out of the way and answers with a big right hand. Here's that dump. Sogra attempted it once, but then he was able to get it on the second try.
Now scoring round by round as opposed to the overall. Both men trading roundhouse kicks early. Skipping up here is Sami Sana, throws a roundhouse to the left rib cage.
Those kicks are starting to land.
Checks the low kick to Sami Sana. Counters off the roundhouse kick with a right hand. Well done by the Frenchman. Drifts back to center cage. Jab from Sogra. Sami Sana comes forward. Roundhouse kick again off the back leg. Both athletes certainly loading up the kicks as the prime weapon of both these men. Overhand right from Sogra, counter right hand from Sami Sana. Went for an overhand right of his own. Inside leg there from Sogra. Overhand right misses again for Sana. Sogra doing some showboating. Sami Sana does some too. They touch gloves, the crowd loves it.
But Sogra seems to have figured out the range of Sana. He's sliding out of the way and he's countering really effectively.
Sweeping leg kick from Sami Sana. front kick. Sogro smiling at his opponent. Center says, come on, come dead center of the cage. Let's throw down toe to toe. Roundhouse kick. Center tried to catch it. Went for a counter overhand right. Shakes his head. Disappointed he misses the target. They're going at it one for one here. He will draw the short straw. Whipping high right roundhouse kick. Sogro had to lean back like Fat Joe to get over the rail of it.
He's doing the Fat Joe very well, Michael. He's evading a lot of these shots and connecting on shots of his own.
Switch stance momentarily there from Sami Sana. Sogro drifting backwards. Sana thought about the right hand. Calls him back to center cage. Just come on! Sami Sana playing some mental games with Sogro, trying to establish himself as the apex predator, as the alpha male between the two.
But I don't know if Sogro is going to get sucked into that game. He's doing really well fighting off his back foot like this. Watch as he's stepping back. He's countering. He's not taking a lot of damage in this round.
Catches the kicking leg. Referee Onari breaking them. Final stages of the second round. Big roundhouse kick there from Sogro. Both men certainly enjoying themselves. Putting on a show. The crowd's loving it. And we are seeing some absolutely ferocious striking technique.
You can see Sana, he's tired of the backpedaling of Sogro. He can't find the distance. But I think more than anything, it's frustration.
Referee Onari is breaking them. When you do clinch up, you've got to throw the knees. They've got to be continuous. Good parry of the roundhouse kick there from Sami Sana. Catch and counts up. Two bites of the cherry, three bites of the cherry. Oh, Sami Sana! A beautiful catch and counter! Gets the knockdown on Sogro! Stunning from Sami Sana! What Sogro couldn't do, Sami Sana achieved! My word, how about that from Sami Sana?
And Sana just put himself right back in the match. That's a big score right there.
And it's a confident booster. Here comes Sami Sana. House on fire, the Frenchman. Unloading the heavy artillery. Sogro's got some ground to cover now. 2 minutes remaining. Overhand right from Sami Sana. Sogro with the right hand, the left hook, they clinch up. The knee to the midsection from the tie. And referee Onari breaks it.
That was a big right hand landed by Sami Sana. Now let's see if he can capitalize on it, because if the scoring looks like it might for that round, that's a big, big plus in the column of Sami Sana.
Good counter right hand again there from Sami Sana. The Frenchman having a stellar final round. Right hand lead down the corridor from Sogro. Pops out the jab. Roundhouse kick to the ribs. Catch and sweep there from Sami Sana. 1 minute 10 remains, third and final. Sana fakes the right hand. Thrusts out a jab. Body shot from Sogro.
Sani rubbing his belly like, that didn't hurt. You might have got me, but it didn't affect me.
Leans out of the way of the high left roundhouse kick. Confidence flowing, oozing out of every pore on the Frenchman. He fakes again. Sogro comes forward. Left hook from the tie. Throws a knee to the midsection, and referee Onari breaks it.
The frustration has been replaced by confidence after getting that big knockdown. We got 35 seconds to go. Who is going to do it?
Jabs from Sogro. Look at Sami Sana smiling at him, ripping the high right roundhouse kick. Body shot, then head on combination from Sogro. He stunned him with the right hand. The final seconds now. Sogro comes forward, another big right hand. And the uppercut. Sami Sana locks him down, ties him up. And Rafael Nari breaks them. Is there one big shot left here from Sogro? It's the right. And Sami Sana does a pirouette, dances out of the way. What a way to finish the third and final round. This is one super series.
Another entertaining match in the one super series. Look at Sorgrok catching the kick, landing a shot, tries the dump, tries to sweep out the legs, but Sami Sana showing excellent balance as he catches a shot of his own.
By unanimous decision from the blue corner,
a little bit rangier.
Kathlon's got heavy leg kicks. Pongsir Mitsatit's got beautiful knees. Nice wide stance coming out of Pongsir Mitsatit. We've seen in the past, Pongsir Mitsatit's got good defensive wrestling, but how's he gonna handle his first takedown here? Well, immediately, Robin Kathlon jumps on the back of Pongsir Mitsatit, gets one hook in, slides that second hook in, now he's looking to rear naked choke.
Gotta be careful about punches to the back of the head. What started that was a heavy right hand from Kathlon. Now, how could he work this through, Mitch?
The first thing Pongsir Mitsatit's got to do is try to put his back on the mat. So he's got to try to turn and twist into Robin Kathlon, but maybe go chest to chest. Good job by Pongsir Mitsatit to possibly avoid there a rear naked choke. He was able to put his back on and get back in the guard. Robin Kathlon's going to try to play the leg game here. He drops down and he attacks the leg. This is what he wants.
Oh, that's
going
the
after heel hook.
We've seen him win multiple times this way before. It's all Pongsir can do to unleash a hammer blow or two to try and distract him. But now he's concentrating on the hands that are suppressing that heel.
Good job
can
by Pongsir
them? Pongsir. He can, but it's not over yet.
He's got to try to separate the hands. He's got to try to separate those hands. He can possibly turn, put his right foot on the butt of Robin Kathlon and push off to create a little bit of space. But a good job by Pongsir Mitsatit to avoid two bad positions right there.
And not only did he wriggle free, Mitch, but he went straight in for the right hand and now the knees to the body. And, oh, it looks like there's been an illegal blow, which is, it looked like to me as if the fight had, as if the contest had been ended.
Connects there on the right hand, presses him up against the K, the circle there. That, ooh.
Oh, that looks high. That looks very high. So far, I don't see anything illegal. That's difficult to see. We didn't get a good view of the third one. We had some entertainment before that happened, and it's bound to pick up where it left off.
But Pongsir Mitsatit was correct. With both these guys' game plans played out perfectly in the first 2 minutes of this round.
Oh, right hand from Kathlon, but he was the one that went to the ground. Every blow that Mitsatit lands, this crowd goes crazy.
And Pongsir Mitsatit packs a wallop at strawweight. On the knee again, lands to the body.
That's a bit of a risk, isn't it? Sending those knees in again. He doesn't want to get penalized again, but these are all legal as far as we can see. And every time they land, the crowd makes noise.
Oh, he's going after the single leg. Turns the corner. He should have turned the other way. He turned into the good balance leg of Pongsir Mitsatit. See how Pongsir Mitsatit puts his left leg in between the legs of Robin Kathlon? It just gives him a little bit better control.
This crowd having a great time. Every blow. Oh, the right uppercut just grazed. You're having difficulty seeing when Mitsatit lands. Just listen, because the crowd will tell you. 2:10 left in this opening round. We had that little stoppage for Kathlon to recover from an illegal blow. The knees come raining in again.
Actually, Mitsatit could turn the corner here and take Robin Kathlon down.
Oh, it's
the knee again!
But it was the rib, surely. That was high enough. Take a look at the blows that did it.
He is so dominant inside the clinch. Look how he has that gable grip locked there inside the clinch. He's pulling down. That one lands right there above the chest. And
that
you can
the
just
one.
See
that was
Robin Kathlon crumples.
Just look below the pectoral muscle.
Pongsir Mitsatit calling his shot, going Nostradamus here in Bangkok, Thailand.
Rodlek, known by one of the best nicknames in the sport, the Steel Locomotive, against the hitman, Liam Harrison. Good outside thigh kick to start off there from Harrison. In a 110-match career, Harrison only ever been defeated once with a headshot knockout. That is an amazing achievement. good outside of the kick again.
You can definitely see the speed differential between these two when they throw their leg kicks. You can see how Rodlek kind of turns his hip over, but Liam Harrison just kind of throws that snappy leg kick.
Oh, the combination! Rapid fire there from Rodlek. That was beautifully done. Four-punch combination followed by the exclamation mark with the leg kick. Four-ounce gloves in a Muay Thai contest, 3x3. No room for feeling out. You've got to go hard and fast under these one Super Series Muay Thai rules. It's all about action. And we're seeing plenty of it so far in the first round. Good stiff jab there from Rodlek. Outside leg kick again from Harrison. Rodlek needs to start checking those. Goes to the inside leg, hoping for that femur profunda. Then goes to the common peroneal nerve above the left knee of Harrison. Left hand again. That lead hand, a trip hammer for Rodlek. Harrison probing. Outside leg kick from the Brit. Nice high guard here from Liam Harrison. On the outside, Rodlek controlling center ring. Long-reaching jab from Harrison. Jab, body shot, step through knee attempt from Rodlek. I love the combination so far from Rodlek, PK, Sanjay, Muay Thai Jim.
Yeah, when he's not throwing just one shot, when he's not just throwing that leg kick, you start to see him put those combinations together. Right now, Liam Harrison's only throwing one shot, but it's also starting to do a little bit of damage. You can start to see that left leg welt up there on Rodlek. But when Rodlek puts those combinations together, man, it's something special.
Three judges ringside are scoring this on a 10-point must system. So if you're scoring at home, wherever you're watching in 140-plus countries around the world, you score 10 points for the winner of the round, 9 points for the less dominant athlete of the round. Oh, a high kick from Harrison, and that went agonizingly close. That was fast. That was lightning fast. And then down to the leg kick from Harrison.
Harrison's definitely got that speed advantage.
Harrison relying on the single shots. Rodlek with the combinations in the opening round. Another combination string there from Rodlek. Uppercut elbow. Leg kick from Rodlek. Body shot to an outside leg kick from Harrison. That's the combo from the man from the UK. The hitman smiles at him. Oh, he has tenderized that lead quadriceps of Rodlek, PK, Sanjay, Muay Thai, Jim.
Oh, nice. Look at that four-piece combination there thrown by Rodlek as he goes one, two, three, and then finishes with that leg kick. Beautiful combination work there.
Two men who between them hold 11 world titles. Two of over 130 martial arts world champions in one championship. Jab from Harrison. There's the outside thigh kick. Three in a row. How do you do a hat trick from Harrison?
Doubled up on it.
Dragging that leg kick is an absolute house on fire. Faster than a speeding ticket for Liam Harrison.
No, we don't give speeding tickets to athletes here, but Liam Harrison might need one there. We wanted combination work, but he sold combination work with just one shot.
And you know Rodlek's a little frustrated because he smiles at Harrison, which means Harrison's connecting. Harrison's hurting him. It's beautiful legwork from Liam Harrison. Oh, the left hook there from the Brit. Oh, connected with the right hand, and Harrison goes down. A single right hand from Rodlek to the jaw. And the first count on Harrison. And how the tide turned so quickly on a dial in the sport of Muay Thai.
Just like that, he turned those knuckles over and put him down with that jab. You can see how Rodlek's changing that guard. He's moving back and forth between southpaw and orthodox. Here come the leg kicks.
Has Harrison recovered? The leg kicks are not slowing down the hands of Rodlek, which is amazing considering the punishment that lead leg has taken. And here come the combinations of Rodlek again. He calls Harrison forward. The crowd is eating it up. They're loving every moment of one Super Series Muay Thai. Harrison with the left hook, smack bang on the kisser. Outside leg kick from Rodlek. Combination work from Harrison. This one's a match of attrition. This one's a beauty. To an up and up, one championship legendary quest. Harrison glances towards his corner. He's on the outside again. Drifts off to his right. Away from the power side of Rodlek. Rodlek next step through knee, hope for the liver section. A couple of minutes ago, Dragon.
Start to see Rodlek trying to find a home for that big right hand of his, and as he's setting it up with the stance changes, when he switches to orthodox, you know that right hand is coming. Harrison's got to be careful when he starts throwing those leg kicks, and he's opening up with that right hand.
The confidence of Rodlek has sunshine on the edge. Second knockdown there on Liam Harrison.
I think Harrison kind of knocked himself down there. He threw that right hand so hard that he spun around himself and lost his balance. Oh, big right hand.
That uppercut almost took out the ceiling lights. Leg goes downstairs to Harrison. Goes a little higher on that occasion. It's been a bad round for Harrison. It's been a great round for Rodlek, who calls him on. The three-time world champion, Rodlek, owns the round.
There it is. There was that right hand that just touched the top of the temple there.
Mitch, you can see why they call Rodlek the steel locomotive, because he's continually coming forward. Both men are masters at it. They hold 11 world titles between them. Has been Rodlek's contest so far. After a good first round from Harrison, and twice in the second, a lot of ground to cover, and that's how he may do it. The rapid fire handiwork from Liam Harrison.
They're testing each other's chins, so they're coming down to who can wear the punches the best.
Harrison needs to knock down Rodlek. Rodlek flowing with confidence. The steel locomotive comes forward again, adjusts his tracks, tries to clinch up with Harrison. Little slip there.
Go!
Even when Rodlek switches to that southpaw stance, Harrison's still trying to go across the body, still attack that leg.
Chopping leg kicks again, a shade of blue and purple on that left leg of Rodlek. Right hand from Harrison. Good check there from Rodlek, smiles at Harrison.
Harrison knows he's hurting him with that leg kick.
That's why Rodlek is switching stance between southpaw and orthodox. The southpaw will protect the lead leg. That being the left leg, it'll switch it to the back, make it the rear. Good cracking right hand there from Harrison. This has been an absolute beauty. This has been Muay Thai 101. Another big leg kick to the left leg. The handiwork from Harrison goes to the shin. A little bit of showboating from Rodlek, the entertainer, the three-time world champion.
Yeah, and right there, Harrison should have lit him up when he had his hands posed in the air, thinking he was Karate Kid.
Oh, another leg kick! Here comes Harrison! Here comes the hitman! But he can't drop it! He stunned him, but he can't drop it!
He wobbled him a little bit. It's there. This is Harrison's round. If he wants to take it with him, he needs a knockdown, though.
No doubt about it. Harrison's round so far. Just over a minute remaining.
Go!
Both men exchanging heavy leather in 4 ounce gloves. Good check there from Rodlek. Smiles on Harrison. Harrison doesn't smile back. He's concentrating, looking for an opening, looking for a chink in the armor of Rodlek. Something that may drop Rodlek Pika Sunshine Muay Thai Gym.
You can see just how accurate Liam Harrison is. When Rodlek tries to cover up, he's able to cut right through that and find that hole.
25 seconds remains. Can Harrison find a knockdown? More combinations than a back set, but still, he cannot drop Rodlek. A flying elbow from Harrison. He cuts off the defense, and Rodlek said, is that all you've got? You've got to do more than that. This has been one of the greatest one Super Series contests we've seen.
You know, Rodlek might be showing us that these shots don't hurt him, but they are scoring on him. And he opened him up bad, Michael. Superman elbow. That's what lit him up right there and opened up Rodlek. Nice little slapping right hook there by Rodlek as he tries to skip it. And that was the shot. That was that Superman elbow that split him open.
By unanimous decision from the red corner, Rodlek PK Sentai Muay Thai Gym.
Also has wins over Tech Sakta, Satsong Pinong, and Coke Chanawat. Saemapetch Fairtex looking big, looking well prepared for this one. Now first striker and already launching the heavy artillery off that left leg. Good jab two combination there. Drops the two down to the Chester's top inch. From Topic. Topic, American with a rare style of Muay Thai, that beautiful style of Muay Thai. We saw it earlier from Lertziller. It also Topic is an exponent of it. A lot of finesse, a lot of clean technique, a lot of subtle movements. You've got to keep a close eye on things that Topic does. Double roundhouse kick and nice evasion from Topic. Just little movements like that, Mitch, that have set Ognjen Topic apart.
And you can see Topic is trying to be last, but you can just see that Saemapetch is just a little bit faster. He's always trying to end that exchange with a shot of his own, and everything comes off that left side. I said big right hand in the open, but it's that left hand that he throws so effectively.
And let's not forget, they are competing in 4-ounce gloves tonight. That makes a big difference. The power that they can load in these 4-ounce gloves is incredible. The impact.
Power is different, but the defense is also different. They have to kind of create a shield around themselves, and they actually have to defend completely different with little gloves than they do with big gloves. And these guys spent their entire career in big gloves. Oh, there's that straight left hand.
Already can see damage on the forehead of Ognjen Topic. Maybe a cut just below the hairline on Topic. Three judges, circle side, are scoring on a 10-point must system. Winner of the round gets 10 points. The test dominant boxer gets 9 points. Usually in the case of a knockdown, it will be a 10-8 round. They are allowed to clinch up and grapple in this one for as long as they like, so long as they are keeping busy in the clinch. Nice counter overhand left there from Saemapetch.
I'd like to see Topic start circling to his left, get away from that power side of Fairtex. You can see he's just standing right in front of him. He just caught one right on the chin there.
Already the damage on the face of Topic. Oh, Topic gets caught again. Here comes Saemapetch Fairtex. Topic in a whole lot of bother now. And referee Delapsis puts a standing count on Ognjen Topic. Now, the scoring criteria of one Super Series Muay Thai, the knockdown score the highest, followed by internal damage, accumulated damage, superficial damage, clean strikes, and aggression and circle generalship. Already, you know that Saemapetch is winning this round convincingly. Good inside leg kick there from the Thai world champion. One knockdown already, a standing count on Ognjen Topic.
Saemapetch Fairtex that we're seeing in the opening stanza here at one Super Series. Look at that beautiful right uppercut to straight left hand. Wobbled Topic. Topic tried to come back, get back into the round, but then Saemapetch turned it up again. He throws that right hook beautifully, and there's the nice little left hand again that clipped Topic.
And that's what I like from Topic, the jab to the high round kick.
This is definitely a more aggressive Saemapetch Fairtex than we saw against Oliveri Ramazanov.
Heard there were some very serious words had with Saemapetch at Fairtex training camp that he needed to step up the game for this one, take it to the next level. And already the Muay Thai world champion is showing that. Back there from Ognjen Topic.
Nice dump from Topic.
That'll score for Ognjen Topic. Pitch up roundhouse kick there from Topic. Three-time Muay Thai world champion from New Jersey in the USA.
Watch that left hand of Saemapetch. Nice little evasion, lean back, counter the shot of his own.
Crowd here in Manila absolutely loving the one Super Series Muay Thai. Saemapetch smiling, Topic just charges in and overcommitted on the right hand and upended himself there.
Gotta be careful not to overextend.
Again, Topic is standing flat-footed in front of Saemapetch. I don't know if that's the right game plan here for Ognjen Topic. Inside leg kick, doubles up and it goes high. Little slip there from Saemapetch Fairtex. The speed and power both these men are throwing. Two world champions in the circle. Outside thigh kick from Topic. Saemapetch with a jab, southpaw stance on the Thai. You'll find if you do a bit of research on how many Thais are left-handed, I should say. Most of them are. Most of them are compete southpaw. Jab two there from Saemapetch. Oh, why so many ties are left-handed? Is that way?
I think it's just a strategic thing. I think they like to just change things up and give their opponent something different to look at. Saemapetch looks like he's having fun out there, evading the body shots, moving around, answering.
Double forearms guard against the round kick there. Topic edging forward, wants to be striking first here.
Stop.
Oh, knee to the midsection, and referee Delapsis breaks him. That was a cracking knee off the left there from Saemapetch Fairtex. Fairtex isn't, in fact, his given name. Has adopted their gym name as their last name. Hence, earlier on, you saw Mercilla Phuket top team. Here you see Saemapetch Fairtex out of the Fairtex training center. Dodson Clyde Fairtex and Stan Fairtex. Not the same family. Same training family, of course, but all the same gym.
Beautiful counter left hand by Fairtex. As Topic came in, parried down, went straight through, and touched him right on the head with that beautiful left hand.
Two rounds down, one remaining here. Smiles on the face of both of these men. Some better signs there from Ognjen Topic.
Another good round from Saemapetch Fairtex. Look at that beautiful counter. 1-2 on the left side. There he is evading, coming forward. Nice little sweep out there.
Good match so far for Saemapetch. Southpaw tie. 4 ounce gloves on both these combatants. Combination there from Topic. Saemapetch goes high on the femoral profunda. High kick and Topic just guarded up in time. Double roundhouse off the back leg there from Topic. Deep kick to the midsection from Topic. The hematoma you see on the forehead was incurred in the opening round. Topic needs to get those legs really dancing here. The third. Pet's pulling the trigger on his power salvos.
Just see the force that Fairtex is throwing. Even that inside leg kick is moving the entire body of Topic.
Hipping high round kick off the back leg there from Topic. Hoping to loop the shin around the back of the neck. Front kick from Topic. Sitting back a little too much, or is he waiting to counter Saemapetch, hoping that Saemapetch will leave a gaping hole in his armor. Jab two there from Saemapetch. That had speed and sting behind it.
Those 4 ounce gloves can change with the course of a match very, very quickly. All Topic needs is one, especially with that big right hand that he's throwing.
On our main card coming soon, it's going to kick off with the One Super Series debut of Anderson Braddock Silva. He takes on Andre the Giant Munier. Two heavyweights in the circle in 4 ounce gloves. That's going to be crazy. Also, Ibrahim Albun, he takes on Andre Stoica later on tonight. Jab again from Saemapetch. 110 remains, third and final. Unofficially on our scorecards, we have 10-9 first, 10-9 second for Saemapetch Fairtex. Good clinch and knee there from Fairtex. Dump attempt from Ognjen Topic, then goes upstairs. The three-time world champion just gets tossed to the canvas. Bobs up again for Ognjen Topic. Comes forward, doesn't commit, now he does. Backs Saemapetch against the circle fence. Both men trade knees.
Stop.
And a dump from Saemapetch.
Up.
Good job by Saemapetch. He hasn't pulled enough of that gas. He's still applying a lot of pressure. He's waiting, he sees what Topic is doing. Topic is rushing forward. He's just waiting for his shot, and he's picking Topic apart.
Topic tried to fire the right hand. The distance wasn't there, and Saemapetch picked him off nicely. This has been Saemapetch on the top of his game tonight. A big elbow from Topic and another one. Two elbows, overhand elbows, make it three. And a back elbow from Topic. A house on fire in the final seconds. The elbows. Ognjen Topic stealing the show at the end of the match with an elbow fest.
Oh, beautiful. Look at that. Topic threw the big right hand. Fairtex saw it coming, swept out the leg.
And then look at that, those four-ounce gloves touching Saemapetch on the chin right there, right as he swept out that leg.
By majority decision, from the red corner, Saemapetch!
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.